Test, test, test. Okay, I think it's working. Hello. I don't think there is. Anyway, I'm going to start these 1 hour sessions, hopefully once a week, to do a jigsaw puzzle. 1,000 piece set. Maybe a few days. Or a few weeks if I'm doing it once a week. Most days to do it, so it'll be most likely Thursdays at 9 p.m., which is like Seattle, Los Angeles, that kind of thing. 2 weeks, 2-3 weeks ago. Always wanted one. Did one when I was, when I had returned to school. That during a winter break when I was on campus. Picture of anything, it looks like a digital image, a computer generated or artist, digital artist of hot air balloons. Let's see if I can get a good, better picture of it. Obviously, I'm going to start with the edges for and sort of a drawing board made of taped. I cut some index cards in half on the edges so that minimize the loss of pieces. In the bag. Oh. Okay, well that's actually a good I noticed that there are just wondering what people do when they're just chatting. I mean sometimes it's like games that aren't listed or you know and I actually saw two other people doing puzzles. Jigsaw puzzles. Tables. That's nice. It's like tiny red piece. But I think it was like already put together. I'll just sort of take them apart. I don't want to put them together. I kind of would prefer like a photograph. It's like fine floss, and I saw it. I was like, why? Sort of curious how much they cost at the place that I was getting my floss, my dental floss. And I was like, okay, I'll start by. A corner piece on the batteries. I'm too sure this will fit. This a bit bigger than that. Where is it? Nice. Okay. 69 centimeters. Here. My graphics card. It's gonna sound like a joke. My offer. Right. Well, I won't lose connection. If I lose connection, I'll just reload. Internet. Good connection. Who's listening, whatever the date or, you know, hope you're having better days or benevolently lice, you know, with good nom noms, you know, satisfactions in regards to endeavors, relaxing, happy, or occurring. Pieces. I haven't seen a corner piece yet. The drawing board is sitting a bit high, so I've got to raise my that uncomfortable, but it's the best I could do for here. Flight workout. I saw this YouTube channel. I don't know if it was called Karen's Puzzles. This person was like, at least when the video that I saw, they were going to like some tournament, and that was kind of cool. But I looked into their channel. They did a lot of puzzles, jigsaw puzzles, which were really neat. That was like a long, like I think last month or November. Oh, I'm currently doing this on the 12th. January 2023. Not that it matters, but this. I'll upload it to my channel. Probably do it. Don't do like an interchange. But somewhat of a workout. Somewhere going to the edge. Oh, no corner piece yet. Not that I'm searching. Just two pieces. Kind of worried that this is gonna like be really short. It's 1,000 pieces, so it should be a while. One of my last puzzle, I think. Never been in an air balloon. I think they're kind of cool. I wouldn't mind if air dirigibles, slow cargo, but you know, I think before that, they should consider like sails, open sailing ships, and maybe another. Now that's kind of a bad way to do it, I guess. But you know, carriages that could be effective. But you know, basically for non-really urgent stuff. Or that's something that's close by if you have like an island. If a lot of places that have island systems, their stuff is actually still grown up in their upper area to rely on other things. But it's currently 9:16. Let's see what else. Recently, Fairy Library. I got to see the, I think it was like 2021 or 2022 Batman. It was kind of nice. It was like a detective film, a mystery film. So that was interesting. I wasn't quite sure what it would be about. Edge piece. They're together. A lot of edge pieces are kind of together, which is kind of annoying. No corners yet. I used to do jigsaw puzzles a lot when I lived in Kodiak and in Florida in the early to late 70s. I didn't know what they were called. They're fun. Probably not as a kind of way. I mean, I probably thought it was. Third-party material or material that might connect to their intellectual property, Dungeons and Dragons. It's kind of a negative change, I think. And kind of weird. Sometimes companies, they feel they have the legal obligation to. I don't think they have to do it, but I think they kind of face. They get threatened with legal actions from within. Kind of, there is kind of a thing where they're supposed to help the community, supposedly. That's kind of too bad. But anyway, a lot of companies are now just moving and have to. Yeah, that's kind of sad. I've only really played Dungeons and Dragons First Edition a lot. And up to kind of the almost late 80s, I was outside. I was tempted when second edition came or was coming, so it didn't really occur to me. I was always still playing first edition with others. And then around that time, I found a corner piece, something attached to it, so I'll just take it apart. Yes, here it is. My first corner piece. Let's see. Bring back the picture. So it's either the top right or the top left. Okay. There we go. Come on. See. There. Yep. Well, whatever. Okay. I think it might be the, for now, I'll put it on the top. So, there you go. And if it's not, well, then I can always change it. I mean, it's like. But anyway, around. Things started to shift a little during my computer games got a little bit better. I mean, I was still into computer games. Well, I was still into Dungeons and Dragons during the 80s. And you had like Ultima 3, which was really a nice, you know, sort of computer RPG party based game. And then I played that. Well, I played a friend on my own until like much, much later. But while I was overseas, you had to US Spaces Library. See what was coming out, and I saw Bard's Tale, which was Electronic Arts at that time. They're a lot younger company. I'm not sure if it was a Creative Arts or something, it was like the advertisement for it was so nice. Fireplace at a tavern and a bard you know, and the adventures around it. It really got the sort of feel. That was like one of the good feelings of Dungeons and Dragons. I mean, I would play the game later when I got back to the U.S. in like late night. My Amiga 500. That was a really nice thing. Found another that was connected. When I got back, I was sort of busy with college and then career, so I didn't really look into things. Kind of wish I did. There's a lot of interest in gaming systems, you know, started doing more with Games Workshops, so Warhammer. I hadn't really seen, except for maybe when I was like visiting a hobby gaming store. And at that point, I wasn't quite sure how long it had been out. So, but anyway, so, you know, it's kind of like really what Hasbro did in trying to, well, basically change the their open source. And it'll be interesting how it turns out. Okay. Video game wise, I like to play other games. I play games over via Twitch on two computers. This particular one is a lot slower machine with a lot less capacity. Hence, you might hear the occasional loud drone of a fan. The other one, which is this one's on a half system. Isn't that too much stronger, but it can, you know, play a little bit more games. I don't have access to a controller, so I'm kind of limited to just keyboard and mouse. It's just really time and access to the internet. But play more science fiction games. But something that, you know, isn't too annoying. Oh, another flat piece. Nice. Edge piece. Like bottom with something. Okay, found another one. I should probably do it systematic. My arm is at a weird angle. I can't change it because it's so challenging. It's 26, okay. I already have a safe place to store this, so it should be okay. Oh, I stored it. I'd rather do this a little bit more earlier, but I think this is like something with some regularity. I will upload this on my YouTube channel. Not quite right away. Load this and then upload it. And that takes a long time. So if this interests you, I mean, you know, my schedule turns out wacky. This is not, you've got other things to do. Which is okay. You can probably see my progress on YouTube. Which is kind of interesting. Twitch games, kind of like Call of Duty, or the earlier, or some forms that where you had like a fast read. Not that I didn't. Was this an edge? Yeah. Not that I didn't play games. I mean, I don't play games too much. I think when Twitch came out, I really didn't have access to games. So, took me off. And then one of my friends, when I went to return to school over at Washington State University in Fulton, he wanted to do a channel. He was inspired by Respect, the doctor that with the wig and the stash, who really skilled, by the way. I mean, that's amazing. And so he did some games which were really neat, like Bomber Crew, stuff that he could do while hanging. Also, doing with work, and, you know, with family. I believe he was married. And I met him through the student veterans office, so that was kind of neat. He had started with one, joined another, because he had time, and obviously school costs money, even for those that can. He wanted some steady viewership, and I don't think, I mean, yes, that'd be kind of nice, but it's kind of hard to have. I mean, people have lives. I mean, whoever's listening now, you know, for whatever reason, you've got stuff to do. There might be a clip that you're just waiting to watch, and, you know, you might get the opportunity, and whatever, you might see a good book. I feel like by chance, science of them. The Intrepid series by M.D. Cooper is really good. She's written a whole series, sort of this colony ship that is to their, like, you know, trying to get to a colony so that, you know, they unload their colony. Time dilation, you know, many, I think it's like hundreds, at least hundreds of years in the future. But technology, sort of, known space has decreased quite a bit, and so they're like at a high advantage. Kind of, not, I wouldn't say it's lighter. It's almost lighter. By Julia Huni, the Space Janitor series. But also within that same universe is like this group called Earth Core. Janitor series kind of goes ahead. It's like a couple years where the Earth is some family that, well, basically, most of the Earth population has pretty much gone to the stars because of you. And so there's like this group just waiting their turn for the ship, but something happens, and so they're stuck there on Earth. And I won't spoil it, but I would say it's a little bit more serious. I mean, it's not like hardcore things are happening, but they don't, the writers keeps it at a, like a PG. So that's nice. I'm not sure if the video is still there, but I also like, I mean, one of the nice things that I have used is like having an e-reader. I've always kind of had one, nothing like sophisticated until a couple of years back. Well, it was on sale at Woot, but it's an old Fire Kindle, and it's really nice. I used some books for school, was available online. I think I had to watch out was battery power. Nothing over the language, and then having the Kindle go out and like, oh no, I've got homework to do, and I need to sell the physical copy of the book, which is actually right in front of me, but I can't reach it. It's like 6 inches away. I won't say what language is, because I'm actually bad at languages. I love languages, but I'm not really good at them. But I love learning about them. My pronunciation skills, I won't really blame it on being an American, though. I mean, you're Analex, but it's not all Americans. I mean, some can roll their R's, I'm envious of that. And U.S. doesn't have an official language anyway. I mean, there was a time where, you know, could have been speaking German until sort of the leadership I won't say the leadership, but kind of the ruling power started making it harder for German speakers. I'm not German, by the way. It's just one thing that are interesting. And of course, you know, we've got languages that are indigenous to this land. There are others. But again, a lot of different possibilities. And of course, you know, young nation. We've had, you know, different languages. Okay, 9:32. That's okay. That's boring. Oh, I brought my water. That's good. Yep. Oh, I'm gonna destroy your tree. Sort of balancing the table on her, and then on one end it's like part of the half PC. It's kind of like a desktop almost, but small. And then also a computer a film lens, sorry. Yeah. Okay. Noticing it, just doing it carelessly. So back to being more careful about it. One film I want to watch is something about everything. It has Michelle Yao, and I've had that reserved in my library. Also, actually, I had the Batman library. I got the Batman. Excuse me. I'm reserving it to the same library, and reserved both films around the same, at least for the Batman film, half a year or more for it to get. And well, that's okay. It's like a DVD copy. Okay. I think for the film, I'm like number 160 something in line. And they've gotten like maybe 4 copies, so eventually. And finally doing email maintenance. Usually I do it every year, but since 2020, it hadn't been sort of busy with other things. When 2020 started, pandemic had become a thing. I had gotten like news that the scholarship that would pay for my food and my rental for the university thing was not approved, and it was, you know, like, oh, I should have known sooner rather than the middle of a school year, in the middle of a year, or between two semesters. And unfortunately, during the height of the start of the pandemic, I had to leave because I just couldn't really charge more, so that sucked. So just surviving. Eventually, at the end of semester, the money did come out, and I was able to pay what I had been charging in terms of credit. Damage had been pretty much done because I'm like, student loans were in a high, and I still have to pay those. And where I ended up. So, I lost that semester, but hey, some people lost relatives, family members. Other corner pieces yet. What other good thing? Recently I found this, I don't know if he's like an architect, but people send him like these pictures and comments about, can they help them with a room? Usually they're a loft type apartment where it's just like one room with everything in it. They ask for help or recommendations, and I don't know, sort of faking an accent like this British guy in that does sort of like this response thing, like Uncle Roger or something like that, or he's faking that accent. But this other guy, he's kind of a Chinese accent, or I don't know if it's Chinese, but so I don't know if it's, but he's still using, I guess, as not only language but pronunciation. I'd be surprised if there's like a book on that right in front of me. I love learning about interior design, but I have the skill for it. It's really bad, but it's kind of, I guess it's kind of like people who watch sports but aren't good at it, but they sort of, there's something about it. So they watch, and I like, you know, stuff like stuff that comes out of Dwell or similar stuff that are either on YouTube or on Instagram that are neat to see. Some aspects of interior design that are really cable, electrical layout. Also looking at, like, if they're doing a restaurant, the flow of how the customers have space. Found another edge, but again, probably in a more careless manner. I should concentrate on this section. Just turn things in.
It's currently 9:41.
So I've got, like, 10 of these, and I'll try to do them at Thursday from 9 to 10 p.m. But I'll also upload them on my YouTube channel, so it's like, don't worry about it. A couple of weeks, you want to see how far I'm at. Hopefully, I haven't, like, once drawing the table, it hasn't, like, it's a drawing board that's being balanced on on stuff in the storage room. These index cards that I placed around.
Another edge, yes.
I didn't really think of trying to figure out how many edge pieces there are. 27 by 20, I think, and each is probably about an inch or less.
Let's see.
It's almost an inch. So let's see. 27 by. So there's. Wait, is it 29 or 27? Let's see. Give us like. There's a picture.
So 40, 27 times 2, it's 54.
So probably around 94 edge pieces. Nothing, you know, it's not like precise.
Did love accounting though.
But professional, you know, not one, but
talents.
So it's actually one of my talents. Though, if you're like
art
managing inventories,
look into accounting,
at least bookkeeping. It's basically, that's what it is when you're managing stuff. Okay, let's see. Keep on going. Oh, and we, of course, play Ray Shadow Legends. I'm going to try and champions. If you can see it, but something got lost or broken. Nothing major, so it is kind of thick. Earlier when I opened this, I found like this red piece, like a head or something, but it seemed to be outside the basket. Some weird thing from the factory. I haven't located it yet again.
like time.
14 minutes left. And then we'll
head off to the other computer and probably fire up a raid
Shadow Legends.
Faster with 2 hours.
That's kind of a choice. I'm surprised. Where I'm at,
usually like puzzles are like $10 to $20.
This was wasn't even that. I mean, it was actually really, really cheap for 1,000 PC even. So that was nice.
Well, maybe that, you know, I should also look at garage sales
or yard sales. So
if I pass one by, I'll check it out.
Oh, is this a corner piece?
And this one is definitely the left corner, left top corner.
See, it's a left top corner. Come on. It's a smaller picture.
Yeah, it is. So I now have both top corners. This one. This one.
So, yeah. I'm going to put that there
and there.
There.
Success.
Actually,
doing this video is a success. I've been.
I wanted like last week to try, but I wasn't quite sure what I can do. Hitting. There's limiting space. I guess my sketch board that I'm using is like 30 by something. I'd say 30 by.
It's 30 by. Hopefully not less than 30 by 20.
Okay, here's a foot. And. Let's see.
I think it's like 19 or 20.
I think it really might really just squeeze in there.
Well, I'll find out. Oh, is it 950?
Yeah, 950. Okay. Not that this is
a race. I don't want to get as much done as I can within that hour.
Pieces, it's like front, a little bit of the top, sides, so a little challenging.
Funny that streaming one time recently played Lords of Waterdeep, which is actually also Dungeons and Dragons based from the Forgotten Realms fictional universe. And this place is the small town of Waterdeep, but it's basically like a strategy card game. It's kind of fun. But for the video game that I play, it's and where the rounds appear is where the Twitch layout kind of shows the viewership. And so as the rounds progress, I actually thought, I was, you know, oh my gosh, there's like four player people watching me. And then it's like, next round, oh my gosh, there's five. And then there's six. And then, I mean, I'm kind of slow on it. I realize, oh, that's my round, not how many viewers are watching. Not that it matters. I mean, whatever. But that's kind of interesting. Connection to this machine is very iffy. So I gotta, as I look into this part, hopefully I can figure out a better place for the camera at another point in time. Actually, I had thought of putting it on the board, which is probably a lot kind of interesting, I guess. But I don't know if you can see much of the pieces. Instead of like shadows moving around. Huh. Is that better? I mean, that's not going to count. Okay. Oh, this puzzle is... It says Kodak Premium Puzzle by a company called Crazy Art. www.cra-z-art.com. This is item 00. So just as for people that are older than 10, or 10 on up. By the way, so just so. Some FYI. I should like have a timer. Again, not that I'm trying to go away, it's only accidentally like stay too long. I wonder if I'll see that weird red piece that I mentioned earlier. Like just like the head of something. But I don't think it's part of the puzzle. I think the puzzle came in. At least I think it was. So. Hopefully within this area. I mean, within the table. I think for like next week when I come back to this puzzle, I'll start pieces that I have. Like basically the sky and the grass. And give them some organization, some appearance. And that'll probably clear out some of the space that I was in there. Nope. At least for this machine, when I was doing linguistical study work, I got a really good microphone for them. The one that I use for Ray Channel, it's basically the webcam. So it's like, I mean, it's okay. But it's not like I can just talk, so I'm just
just restricted to the video on the mouse. Some stuff is getting close, too close to the edge section, or just, I might just push the edge section. I should probably bring some light. Plastic bins from that I can put here on the table, and then I can just put items that are similar or maybe together, like grass and such, together. My dog. Yeah, I'll do that next time. Yeah, I'll do that. Oh, it's 9:59. I don't know if they're the same thing though. I mean, it's a computer thing. But like this one. Wait, will this? No. Maybe there's together. And it's 10 o'clock. So, okay. I'll try to give a glimpse of what I have. We got up. I have the top right corner. And then. Left corner. So we have that. And then of course we got this basically pilot we just opened up. Again, this is the first hour of this puzzle. I will next week. And don't worry about it if you miss it for whatever the time, but we'll put it on the YouTube channel. Thank you. Let's see. Let's type a thank you. Thank you for watching. That appeared or not. I don't think I set a place for the chat to appear on this video. But again, thank you, and benevolent wishes to your evening. And Sci-Fi Obo out. Oh, I will be back later this evening, which I'm alas can't talk, but type. Take care, have a good one, and get some good sleep.